continuing our shiurim on Shai Kavanos, Dush Laila, and we are in the middle of Dush Vav. Now, I think a good starting place would be so maybe I'll just give you a little hakdama. So where are we holding over here? So we are holding obviously in the middle of the night over here, where we're going to experience what's called the Domita. The Domita is, pshat is that we want to build up Nukva, which in this case, at nighttime, it's going to be Leah. Okay? So we want to build up Leah at this point. During the daytime, we want to build up Rochel. So it works a bit differently. The Domita that we find in Shmona Esre, in the word Be'ava, as we find it by nighttime, we want to build up Leah. And how do we do that? So the Domita, very simply said, just to remind ourselves, is that we pull out the Moichim from Zah. Once we pull out the Moichim, what are these Moichim? And where do they come from? More importantly, where do they come from, these Moichim? The Moichim are a constant flow of Shefa that he's receiving from the Nai De'ima. So the Nai De'ima is retracted from Zah, and obviously that is our sleep. When we sleep by nighttime, that's the Domita, we fall asleep. That's because our Morchim go up. That same thing happens to the Zah. It's Faket, because it happens to Zah, it happens to us. And therefore, the Nai De'ima will now shift over and go into Nukva. And when that happens, she gets a boost and she grows. And that's what we want. We want her to grow to the point where she's Kol Koima Zah. She's the whole entire length of Zah. That's Shlab number one.
So she grows to the Gevuros, is that right?
Sorry?
She grows to the Gevuros.
Correct, yeah, that's right. So what the definition is that what usually happens is that Ima will give Chasadim and Gevuros to Zah. Zah will keep the Chasadim, and he'll give over the Gevuros to her. Yeah. So what's going to happen here? When he's out of the picture, she's going to get Gevuros directly from Ima. She gets it directly from Ima without being, because the Mefarshim do explain that even though Zah only gets primarily the Chasodim, but he gets some of the Gevuos as well. That's Mamayit, the power of those Gevuos. But when she receives it directly, when Nukva receives it directly from Ima, she gets a boost of the full power of the Gevuos, and she grows very quickly.
And when does Nukva get it directly from Ima, not from Zah?
By the Domita, by nighttime.
Dafka
by the Domita, yeah. Yeah. So it's one by day, one by night. So we're talking about the night one now. Now, we're particularly talking about Nukva Leah, as I mentioned, Leah. Leah grows, because Leah is very short. Leah is only from the Das Dezah to the Chozer, in back. So let's start expanding. She'll take over the Kelim of Rochel, we said. And that's how she grows Kol Koma. That's Shlab number one. That's called the matzav of Achorayim. That's when she's in the back. But what we're going to be discussing today is the matzav of what happens beponim. Because it's not good enough just to make her grow. What we want to eventually do is we want her to go ponim beponim is make a zivug and give us the shefa. To Klal Yisrael. That's what we want. That's the whole avoida that we're doing. Not just to grow for the fact of growing. So we did the avoida By nighttime, Tikkun Chatzoyz, Baruch HaMapil, all that. And that's what we're primarily talking about, how the Birkas, the Kriya Shema Lamita here over here, Birkas HaMapil, that does all that. That does all that shifting of the Shefa from Zah into Nukva. Then Nukva will go Ponim B'Ponim. Now, that's the way it's usually described, ponim b'ponim, meaning that she'll go ponim b'ponim and she'll make a zivug. But it's not that straightforward. What's really happening is that, in the same way, kishem that she was a nekuda ketana b'achorayim d'zah, and then she grew up, she'll have to do that whole process again by ponim. It's not that, oh, we grew her by the achorayim, and now we just bring her forward and then make a zivug. No, it's not that at all. she shrinks. That's the lashon of the Arizal. She actually shrinks to Nukuda Katan again. And we have to build up again. We have to build up again. Those are the literal words of the Arizal, but the Mefarshim says is lav dafka. It's not really what really happens, because we know in other places it doesn't say that at all. He says that there's actually two facets of Zara, achoraim and ponim. And if you've done the achoraim, you've done it. There's no shrinking involved. Now what you're going to have to do now is that work with the nekudas of ponim and build that up. So they say that it's lav davka and arizah, it's not that, it's just easier said, it's a kitzur, whatever, but we see in different places, in Etz Chaim and Shaar Kavanos, that there is no shrinking of nukva. So we have to take that into mind when we read these words over here. Nitmat, that doesn't mean actually she doesn't shrink, but she's as if she shrank now, we're starting again to build up her nukudas upon him now. Okay? So let's just summarize here. So what we're talking about is that after we've built her up, her achoraim, and she's full-fledged, kol koma de za, she'll take a move in front of za. But, and she'll join up with her nekudas haponim, which is a nekuda katana. And the ganze avoda that we're going to do at that point, once he's back awake, za's back awake, and he's receiving the shefa directly from Ima again, and he's distributing now the shefa from, now the shefa going from Ima to Zah into Nukva. We're talking about the Nekuda Katana upon him, which was always there. Not that it was Bachurayim and then moved, but rather Nekuda Katana that was always there and that we're going to have to build up.
What's Pshat the Nekuda Katana upon him that was already there? If she was Bachurayim, then it wasn't already there.
Well, that's what we're saying. We say it was always there. There was a Nekuda Bachurayim. There was a Nekuda Bachurayim and there was a Nekuda Bapanim.
Why is there a Nekuda Bapanim? If she was Bachurayim, then she's not Bavonim.
Why not? There's two sides of a person. There's the Panim and the Achurayim.
She's facing away from Zoh.
No, actually we're talking about Leah, which is facing towards Zah in the back of him, right?
Yeah.
That's Leah over there, but that's owner her Nekuda's Achurayim. But she also has another facet of her in the Panim of Zah. By the Yesod Zah, there's a Nekuda Katan. She's the Ateres HaYesod Zah.
So if we're building up the Nekuda, then what's the pull of her going upon him?
Because we want her to be...
We
want her to be Shalom completely, not only to have a Nekuda's Achorayim behind her and a Nekuda's Ponim in front of her, we want her to be a Dovah Shalom, to make a zivug with Zah, which he is Shalom, he has his ponim and he has his achoraim, and therefore that's a zivug shlim.
So we're building up the kudus upon him from the yisod of Zoh.
Yeah.
So that's the lashon nismayit. We go back down to the yisod.
No, she's always there. No, she's always
there, but we want to build it up. So till now.
Yeah, but she's not shrinking. That's the problem.
It's not literally shrinking, but it's shrinking. No?
It's kilu, she shrank. Yeah, because we've been working. She's called Koima. All of a sudden, we're working as Nekuda, as if she shrank, but it's not. Okay? So that's what the... I was just telling you the Diva, the Sodein Shah Rachamim Chelek Beisim, that's the way he learns. And that's the Gladys Mahalik to understand this, and not to mix steels in other places, and it's Chaim with Arizal. Okay, so we're going to start by the words Venimsa. Right in the middle. Venimsa ki kemo shiza choza limidoso arishon ke nukva acher asher higdilo Ach ba'ach, parts of Shalom, keniska, chaza limidosa rishon aliyos besoid nukuda ketan. You have it? What page is it on?
Shin
Samach. So you see clearly that he's saying you have a place?
Yeah.
You have a place? Yeah. So you see clearly that he's saying that she's choizel in nukuda ketana, but as we explained, that doesn't mean it's literal. And what does it mean that za choze limidosa rishon, because that's literal, because he was eser sfiras, but once the domita happens, he shrinks to avak, to only six spheres. Alidea polis domita keniska. Valachain ata, Nikra Tzela Velo Patsov. Zilsha Oma Kotsov Yikach Acha Mitzeloisov. Okay, that means after we fully blown her up to Kol Koima Deza Bachuraim Deza, and now we're going to be starting working with the Ponim Deza, with her Nikudis Ponim, with her Nikudis Ponim, she's considered to be a Tzela, and not a Patsov. Va'acha Shinit Ma'ata, Nasra Matzil Ma'achorov, Va'ala Oisa Lemala Keneged Ponim Deza. So this also, this notion is a little bit problematic. The Mefarshim say, the Shem Sotzen and Soda also is Oymer on this. What does it mean? After she becomes very small, then the Nesira happens. It's Faket. Usually when we grow her totally, then we do the Nesira. There's no point being doing a Nesira when she's in a new Kudu Katana. So this ain't Kilo, this missing Avas Akitzo. It really should be read Va'acha Shinit Mata Chozroba Morchim De Ima Nigdala. Ima goes into her, then she taka grows, and then Nasra Matzil Ma'achorea. That's how it should be read. Vaz Heir Ba Arch Ampin. Then Arch Ampin comes into the picture. Veheshlim Tikuna. Vigdila. Ubono Binan Sholem Kemosha Hail Ba'alu Betchila. Venimtzu'u Ata Shneim Shavim Mamish Ze Keze Odom Vechava. Now, what's Aruch Ampin have to do with this? Which we've been talking about, the Nai De'ima, just as instead of growing Zaya, now the Nai De'ima is going into Nukva. So again, I just have to tell you, the Mefarshim say that Aruch Ampin is Lav Davka. Lav Davka, Aruch Ampin, but it's a higher Koach, and Klapin Nukva, she looks at this higher Koach as if it was Aruch Ampin, but it's actually only the Nai De'ima. The Nai De'ima, which is coming in, and being a mashpia on Nukva over here. Yeah, it's the Erechin, yeah. It's V'achar kach chozra abina l'halbish nai shela b'reisha deza. Lasos lo moichim k'niska le'ed. That means after he wakes up, the mina, which is ima, the nai de ima will go back into za once he wakes up, or that helps him wakes up. And then she goes forward, and the ponim ponim. Amo chayim akosev nirem. Nirem leani azdati ki ze sod alias leia lema. Like I told you beforehand, by the nighttime we're only growing leia because we know that Rochel, where is she? She's in bia. She goes down to bia. She takes only her nukuda ikrit, which is the kesa. She goes down, and leia borrows. As we said, Sheila, she borrows the rest of the Leah. Leah borrows the rest of the kelim of Rochel to make her kol koma deza. That's what we're talking about. Leah. Kemoshin is by Leah bedushim shekad mo v'lechein he keneged ponim mamish deza, because she's behind. Originally, she's behind the back of za. Now she goes in front. Therefore, that's why she's going to be ponim mamish, because she's just going. Just 180 degrees. It's not Efsha, but that's actually what happens. Venasa shteim parts of Echad, Leos, Kilea, him, Achroim, the Ima, Vachain, Alta, Limala, Vahavinze. That's why she's so high, Leah, because she's actually originally, she comes from the Shvirs Kelim of Ima. That's why she got such a high position. Now we're going to start working with the ponim, growing the ponim of Nukva. Bechina achas hi, zush zechanu ata, kinasu beponim beponim, aridei amatzile elyon. Again, amatzile, who's the matzile elyon here? In Kabbalah, we don't just say the Eberster, where we want to be more precise. So this is Ima. Again, the Naidi Ima, she's the only player here, which is growing both either Za or she'll be growing Nukva. She's not growing both in one time. So at this point, she's now growing Za. She's the Matzil Elyon. Ve'az bo el Nukva, gam hi b'chines ponim milimala, min amokom shenim shechu b'chines ponim Za. So there's no real Seder, there's a Rizal, he's going back and forth from the Domita to the Nesira, back when Za's woken, but we know what he means over here. I think you stelled on it last time. This bo. That means the morchim or bo linukva. That means either you learn that it's in the night, the netzach hod yisoid, the v'imo coming in, or the morchim. That's a loshon bo. But when again, the klal is when nukva, when Zah is sleeping, then the bo to nukva, and when Zah is awake, then they go to Zah. That's one shefa. Okay, that's one type of shefa. B'china shnia hi, ki afal pi, fe afal pi shechozim panim b'parim, hu mekeneged achozid Zah v'lemata. Means he. That means Nukva is now, when she goes ponim b'ponim, she's actually a kudi katan, but she grows slowly. She goes only to the chazed zah. B'kishu she'haita omedus b'tchiles b'achorov. Chazra atel yus ponav shu hu ken hu ha'hu atzmo bilvad. V'az nichnasim oiris naid de zah mitzan b'chines ponim shalahem. U'me'irim ba v'nasim ba tlatz moichim. V'enam nimshochim milimala keniska. Kikain al derze biyosa ba'achorav hayu meirim achoraim dinai shelo ba v'nasuba tlat morchi and kiniskaleel. Okay, b'kitzo, there's two bechinas coming to upon him. One is when Zah is sleeping, then the first shefos of the night ima be going feeding nukva. That's the first type of bechina that's growing Leah. And the second bechina, the second type of shefo which is growing Leah, is directly from Zah. She's going to come in front, she'll grow from the Mekudi Katana to the Chazah, and Zah is going to be giving Shefa directly to her. Those
is
are
that,
the,
is that during the Demeter or not?
Called, the Klal is, when he's awake, there's no Demeter anymore. So that's the two Bechinas. One's
in
Demeter, one Demeter, one's Acher Demeter. When built Domita, that means the Ima is going to be growing Nukva. And when he's awake, Acha Domita, then he's growing her from the Chosel Imata. So the Shetida. She'ena kavano loma shenai shelo nasi mamish morchim dila. Omnam kavano hi shenai shelo mi'irim bigulgota dila. Vaz nasi megulgota achas. So what's happening, what he's explaining over here is that when Zah's feeding and growing up Leah at this point, he is not giving her Kalim, but rather, it's not getting the actual morchim, but rather it's only a ha'ora, because she has the morchim already, right? She is what she is. But what's happening over here is just the ha'ora is going over to her.
It helps her to grow.
Aval efsha shilifamim eina nekeva rak shlosha oiras elu denai dezam levadam. Besod moichim de nukva. That means what's happening over here is that how big is she? She's only by the chosid of Zah. So really, all Zah needs to give it to her is his netzach od yisoid, which is the entire size of nukva, and that's how she's getting her shefa.
There's also an Indian that, like Ima, she gets Netzach Nehi Chadoshim, but Zohar doesn't get Nehi Chadoshim because his Nehi doesn't go to Nukva. That's what he means, no?
Say that again, what?
The Nai of Zohar doesn't go to Nukva because, and he doesn't get Nehi Chadoshim.
No.
It's only Ahora.
Right.
That's what it means, no?
Yeah.
I'm asking by Ima, she gets Nehi Chadoshim.
Right, because she's giving over to him her kalim.
Yeah.
Right, correct, yeah. Vilifanim yesh gurua ache gurua mikol zim, vuhusha afilo shlosha oros elu anai deza levadam enom bom sod moichim, rag bichinets nitsutsoits mitnoitzitzim mahem. So another type of shefa that she's getting, Nukva is getting from Zah, is a lower type of shefa, which is called nitsutsoits. Netzutzois. Okay, what is this? The Bechina, this is Bechina Shlishis, because once we said Nukva is receiving from Ima, the other one is receiving from Za, a higher form of Ha'ara, and then she's also receiving from Za, a lower form of Ha'ara, which is called Nitzutzos, and this is Bechina Shlishis. He Bechina's Moichim de Nukva be Me'achol, Shalom is Manet Fila. Because our avoida is mostly by tefillah. That's how we grow nukva. And when we're not doing tefillah, she's still getting shefa from za, but that's called this nitzutzos. Yeah. Okay, so let's continue. Histakel b'shloshes mina morchim elu shel nukva v'zachal. So just we should remember... remember these type of three type of shefas that Nukva is receiving. Veninza mikol ze niska le'er she'arech ampim hu hamapil shena. Now he's going back into the words of the Kriya Shema Lamita. So, and then we remember and over there we mentioned that arech ampim does play a role over there. She'arech ampim hu mapil shena al enei za shelo yistakel bo. Now what is it? Now again, like I said, there's no order in that reason. Now he's talking about again the domita. When there's domita, meaning is that it's not only the night the imor is taken away from za, but also the shefa that which imor is receiving from al champin kiilu closes his eyes and therefore is not mashpia on imor, which then is not mashpia on za. The choza bichina zvak. Then za
closes his eyes.
It's al champin. Hamapir shena al ene. It could be both actually, za as well. That is mapir shena. That he closes. That he's not mashpia on za, and therefore za is not able to mekabel because there's nothing there. And that's ki'ilu. The eyes are being closed. The eyes are being closed here.
Shlel is takel bo means that the za shouldn't look at arich.
No, he says the opposite. That Ari is no long mistakil in the eyes of Zah. And because of that, therefore Zah will then shrink. Instead of 10 spheres, you only have 6 spheres. Chozel bechinas vak v'halidei kain nimshaches tenuma al afa pai zai Zah melagia melash me. Okay, so that's
it's a mistake before. It says the mapir shena alin zai should be the mapir shena alin arach.
No.
Because after it says again that it's numa rafa peza.
Yeah, it's always that. Zah closes his eyes. That means he's not receiving any shefa. Arichu mapir shena al Arich is closing the eyes of Zah. That's what he's saying. Mm-hmm. The eyes of Zah are being closed. Why? Because the Arich is no longer looking at him. Kilo, he's closing his eyes, and is no longer being giving him shefa. Therefore, Kilo, Zah's eyes are being closed.
So there's two things: there's Shena and there's Tnu.
Efshet means Arich makes the eyes of Zah closed.
How does he make his eyes closed?
That's what I'm saying.
There still seems to be two things going on. He doesn't look at Arich and he doesn't look at Nukva.
That's a Shashelis. So what happens is that Arich will no longer be looking at Zah. Zah will no longer, therefore, receiving any shefa, therefore his eyes will be closing, and if his eyes are closing, therefore he will not be able to mashpia any shefa on nukva. Everybody shrinks. Zah shrinks and nukva.
Eyes of the Yisola Shefa.
Yeah. Well, we know it from Otzus Chai, there's a koach, a shmir, there's a koach, a ria, there's a koach. There's a lot of koachas over here, but here it seems to be saying the koach of the eyes. Yeah. I got these all figuratively speaking. There are no eyes here. V'gam yichozer v'chizn nukod achas. V'l'achre kach, achampi niska la'atzmo magdilu meir ele nukva. Okay, since now, again, since Zah is no longer in the picture, he's sleeping, he's out cold, Kiviyochol. Therefore, the higher Shefa, and I told you beforehand, this is Lav Davka Al Chanpin, this is Ima, should be Mashpia on Nukva. Okay? The Torah's Chochem points out that we find this commonly said, that we often use the lotion of the Matzil, or the Ensof. But it doesn't really, we know this doesn't mean the Ensof is being Mashpia. We don't have to go that high. When we're talking about Zah, and we don't say the Ensof is Mashpia on Zah, obviously the Arizal, what it means by the Ensof, means Yisosaba, or Tvuna. You know, he's talking about a lower Shefa, because we don't skip. There's no such thing as the Ensof, which is outside the Mokum Pone, which is Mashpia on Zah. Doesn't make sense. I have to go through all the Adam Kadmon, all the Olomets in order to get the Zah. So we find Dugmos like this. And and another pshat is that the Shemin Sosin wants to say that Al Chanpin is Dafka. What does Al Chanpin have to do with this? Because, like we said, we're not skipping Madregas. It's the Nai De'ima who's Mashpi on Za. But where's the Nai De'ima get her Shefa from? From Al Chanpin. That means the Al Chanpin's Nahi is in Ima. And then Ima's mean Mashpi, all that into Za. So that's why the Arizal chopped onto Al Chanpin. Anu omrum o meir leishon bat ayin ki arich ampi meir ben nukva anikra ishon bat ayin, and she is called, and that's what we say now, the night the imas mishpi on nukva, which is called ishon bat ayin. That's the brocha bochum apil veininu ki beheyois malchus besod nukudo ein ba parts of shalom rak nukuda achas kuludo me eses sfirs, because even she's a little nukuda, remember every nukuda has 10 spheres in it. Aber ein und war Protes. Wir tamen der Malchus und wir beginnen es nukud der Keniska, Kenoda, ad schon uns zurichem, liv neusa bebinyan gomo alide Birkas, Birkas Ovis Keniska. Birkas Ovis, that's when we grow her in that particular begin. I was talking about Rochel over here. Vaz bi Yosef besod nukud azu, az nika Malchus ishon bat ayim besefer zofa tikunim, zofa hetev klal zeh. Okay, and that's what the Zohar. Every time you hear the lotion of Ishon Bat Ayin, you have to know it's a reference to Nukva. Now, why is she called Ayin? So the Shemen Sosin says that, like you said before, she's being, what is she receiving? She's receiving Gvuos. What are Gvuos? Gvuos are Havayas, really. The same Havayas of Chasadim. There's five Chasadim, and there's five Havayas of Chasadim, five Havayas of Gvuos. Havai is 26. 26 times 5 is 130. 130 is the gematria of ayin. So that's what's going to her. She's receiving ayin. That means the five gvuos, the five havayas. That's why she's called ayin. Bas ayin. Veze inen omer meir liishon bat ayin shehu nekuda zois. Ve'alidei ha'arosa ba magdila v'nasi pasuf gomel kinizke le'el. Ve'zo sheteida. Let's see if we can try to finish this. V'sol sh'teida. Ki zo nekuda yichol lamod im za ponim b'ponim b'kol eis v'zman v'zochu gamze. V'inen hakdom abiyu tfilas Rosh Hashanah. Sham izbar be'hetev inen meir ishon bat ayin v'gam b'drush tfilin. Lama nogim b'yom v'lo b'layla nizbar hetev tam leze. והנקודה הזו היא בחינס הקצר שבו ושעה תשע נקודו יצבעים לה בסוד תוספס לבד. Every time we talk about her nukuda, we're talking about the keser. Right? We had a little bit of a steer about that, which nukuda actually goes down to bia, but here we're talking about the keter stays up and the tesha nukuda satachtoyas go down. והכלל אוילי מכל זה, and this is the rule. Ki kol ma shenase be'erev Shabbos bereishis, that means in Parsha bereishis, when we're talking about Adam v'Chava, when we're talking about Adam v'Chava, there were one du patsufim, and then they split, and she was a tzela, and all that, and sira, that happens every single night. Nase ata be'kol laila. That ma'ase bereishis, that ma'ase always happens every single night. Kedei shebeshachis, Because Simshon tells her, "Imo ponim beponim, because she's by the El, because she stayed behind us ponim beponim." Okay, and practically speaking, like we said, every day, every night happens, the door meet also by day, by the because of us, and then by Sim Shalom, that's when they make the Zivug. Venimsa, ki ata belaila hagvus vadinem ashamitza da nukva mizgabrim vi holechas vinigdelos. Like you said before, it's a night time and therefore she's receiving the gvus. And these gvus are helping her to grow. At shenimsa shebeesa boike kol gvuseya mizchabreis binikudet zion sheba. So by night time she receives all the gvus, and then by daytime, all those gvuos that go into her will go down to her yesoid. And then by Sim Shalom, Za and Nukva join together to make a zivug. He brings his five chasodim, she brings her gvuos, and by Sim Shalom they make a zivug. By night time, it's her night.
So
that's when the dinim come out as a gvuz. That's when she's awake and when he sleeps.
Yeah. So at night, the gvuz go into her and give her
directly from Ima. Yeah.
And then the drink from the Esser, she's magdi.
Right? By night time we talk layer. By day time we talk ochel.
Yeah. After the Demeter.
Yeah.
Right. So why don't the Demeter just the gvuz go in?
Which one? The Demeter by day?
By the Demeter by night.
Demeter by night, yeah.
Just the gvuz go in.
That's right.
And then Jewish Men Esther, it's Magdil.
One second, then you have a Chatzot Zalayri, you have a Zivug between Leah and Yaakov, you have a lot of things happening.
So
you have a whole process there. You have the whole system that happens by night.
Right.
And then by day, it's completely a different system.
Right.
Yeah. Yeah. Why by night? Why is she takesh shlita by night? Ki nafla shena al einav, obesa mitzmaser biyoda, besov v'tokum be'od lailo. Ve'ata nivaye, kavonos bekazu, yosef derosav remez ima kol kavona achas, hi im mash ba'anu ve'at ve'akol, Va'kol nikshal zevizet. Now we're going to explain more lemaise, the kavana with the yichudim a little bit, just a little bit to finish off his dosh. Right? So we spoke about all the theory till now, but lemaise, how do we do this? Here we go. Hine bistaklus va'ora ha'elyona nimshach min ha'havaya de abdi yudim el ha'havaya de sag. So obviously, when we're doing this, we have to imagine in our minds what is happening. So we're given by the Arizal a very shameless, which represents these koichas that we're talking about being mashpir one to the other. So the first dimyon that we're given is the havaya de yudim, which is ab, and giving over. We imagine that it's giving over to the havaya de sag. Umisham elavai de ma, umisham elavai de ben. That's what usually happens. With ab, sag, ma, u ben. That's the dagas. So we imagine the shefa is coming from all the way up from ab to sag, uma, u ben. Aval kol zihu besod midas hayom. Ki hashefa nimshal deran azocha. Ki hu o goy v'sholei b'yom. Aval b'layla, she'az amidas l'laylo goveres, nimshach zaro min ha'avai de yudim, de'atzmo der yoshal el ha'avai de ben dimiloi ha'hin. So everything we said till now, that Ab is giving over to Sag, Sag is giving over to Ma, Ma is giving over to Ben, that's all by daytime. But by nighttime, it goes from Ab to Ben. Why? Because Ben is Nukva.
That's what you mean.
And she is the star of the show by nighttime, right? So it's Ab giving directly to Ben.
So that's what we mean from Yisraelima to Nukva.
Yeah. Ve'az mitzmales gam hi, ve'naz is Yudim kemo rishoyna. So our job is to take out the middlemen because they're going to sleep, as we'll explain. So what's going to happen is that the higher bechina of Ab is giving over to Ben, and that Ben will now become like what it receives. It's going to be Havaya de Ab as well. He's going to explain. Because the nirmas bebracha zu. He, when you say those words, Bocha Mapi Chevel Shene Alanai, Mapi, that means you're being mistalik, all the middle bechinas, which in our case, which is Za. Sheyesh b'miloi shlosha yudim anikra enayim, keniska b'tikunim tikun ayin. Because we know that staklav ha'orim me'havaya the sag anikra enay, because what are you doing? Ha'mapil chevel shena me'al enay, so that means you mapil shena al enay. What's enay? Enay is eyes. And you look at the ha'vaya, the sag, has three yuds. Those are round circles, and says Mefashim, that signifies the Enai.
Right.
So we're saying as a remez, we're being mistalik mapil shena chevle al Enai. That means we're taking away sag. All right. Remember, that our goal is to take away the sag of the ma in order to get the ab giving directly to the ben.
Where does sag come in?
Sag is the ab of ima.
Ima is there.
It's all be'erchim. Again, but we're talking about arich as ab. Ima, Abba, which is Sag. Ima, no, sorry, Sag is Abba of Ima. Ma is Za. And then Ben is Nukva. So we want to remove all those middle players, all those middle Patsufim, in order that Arich can give over directly to Nukva. And when we say Utnuma al Af Apai, he mistalku da'ava havai dema the alfi manika af alpai.
So if it's be'erichin,
yeah,
the be'emes sag ma is be'emezo.
No, sag is abba ve'ima, because we're talking about arich. Other parts of it, arich and then abba, then ima, then za. All those three have to go out.
But we're saying that arich is not there.
What do you mean arich is not there? What do you mean?
We don't mean arich. Mean ima, so the only thing that goes out is zo.
Right, correct.
So sagama is them is all zo.
Okay, that's your erachim. The Arizal is making different erachim, right? He's bringing, as he mentioned before, arich. That means he wants to use his erachim arich.
Yeah, I'm saying, but right.
Yeah. I'm asking you. Yeah, that's really what's really happening. Yeah. But he's playing with these with his erichim. V'nikra afapayv ki hu levush el havai desag. Because ma really is a havai desag, is a levush desag. He explains. Keno kishlosha alfim de ma, because the way you spell ma, there's three aleph's in ma. And the way you spell the aleph's of ma is yud vav dalet. And this Yud Vav Dalet is Mechase, the Yudim of the three Yudim of Sag. That's why the Arizal calls that it's a Levush, the Maz Levush to Sag. Vekam Tamache, Kitsu Alofi, Me Mamesh Kidmus Afapayim. So a different reason, because if you look at the Alephs, it's like, because it's a Yud Vav Yud, you can spell also Aleph with a Yud Vav Yud, it's like the eyes, like the eyelids. Kitchen Yudim Achatz Elyonov Achatz Tachtoina. Because you have the lower eyelid and the upper eyelid, those are the two yuds. And I suppose the middle is the slit, or that's the vav. Kidim Dmus Tre Afapayim. So it's another remez to understand that the aleves of Ma or Mechase are the levush for the sag. That means they disappear. Vali de histaklus haro mishteyem, when they histaluk. When they disappear, ha'aro mishteyem nimsheches ha'aro havai de ab the yudim el havai de ben hahi. Then you get, once you mistalik all that, then ab because it must be on ben. She malchus anikra ishon bat ayin ve'inan ha'aro zois he b'chines havchusa lios mloa gam kein b'yudim kemo havai elyon keniska. That's what's going to happen, that we convert her into a full ab as well. Again, in our language would be that the Naidi Ima, like you said, is coming to being Mashpia to Nukva, and then Nukva grows up to be called Koma Deza. In his Lashon over here, when we're doing the Kavanas, we're imagining the ab is going into the Ben, and the Ben grows into an ab itself. And that's how you'll see it in the Kavanas of the Arizal, of the Rashash and the Arizal. Okay, good. So we'll stop it here, and then next time we'll be starting Dush Zayin. Okay, let's go.